Student, we use different colorful, fancy and fashionable clothes. But do you know how these clothes are made? Now today we are going to learn how the clothes are durable and how the clothes are made. The tailor cuts the cloth, take a piece of cloth that he does not need. What do you need? What do you see at its edges or corners? You will see the long threads. Long threads are woven together to make cloth. Use the magnifying glass for this. Magnifying glasses are a kind of lens that is used to make objects appear larger. Cloth or fabrics is made by intertwining threads together. Intertwining threads together is called weaving. Long threads are woven together to make cloth. Cotton cloth is made from threads of cotton wool on machine. Now let's do an activity. Take a wad of cotton wool. Pull at it from either side to make it as long as possible. Lay it on your palm and by pressing it with other hand, roll it in one direction. Note what happens. You will see that the wad of cotton gets twisted into a long wick. This long wick is used for diya, lamps, oil lamps, etc. Earlier, a spinning wheel was used to draw your yarn from cotton, that is a charkha. Nowadays, the same process is carried out on machine. Jute, cotton, these are used for making cloths. Fibers obtained from plants. From jute, we can make the fancy bags and doormats. We use the different cotton clothes. Clothes from things other than cotton. Silk. Silkworm prepares silk threads which can be obtained from its pupa. Wool. Wool can be obtained from the fur of sheep. Artificial fibers. These fibers are man-made and used to make cloth, for example, rayon, terrylene, nylon, polyester, etc. Now, how these fibers are changed to fabric? This is a picture that shows how the fibers are changed to fabrics, that is a cloth. Methods to weave cloth. With the help of needle, sweaters and caps are weaven. Handloom. Machines run with the help of hands are called handlooms. Cotton and silk cloth are usually made on handlooms. Power looms. Machines run with the help of electricity are called power looms. Many types of clothes are made on a large scale using power looms. Cleaning the clothes. It is very important. Our clothes become dirty after we use them due to various reasons. In order to take care of our health, we should wear clean clothes and should also keep them neat and tidy. Wearing clean and neat and tidy clothes is a good habit. Now how do we clean our clothes? We wash our clothes regularly. We use plain soaps, detergent soaps and liquid soaps for washing our clothes. We can also use soap nuts, that is Ritha, washing soda, Hingenbaek and limestone to wash our clothes. These substances are natural ones. Do you know the woman buying old clothes in exchange of new utensil? Answer is Boharin. In the picture, you can see Boharin. Reusing the clothes. Clothes are durable. Even if they become old, they can be reused. We can reuse the clothes in the following ways. Giving these clothes to the needy and poor people. Torn clothes can be made into small articles such as dishcloth, quilts, doormats, etc. Old clothes can be made into new cloth by taking its threads out. Threadbare clothes can be converted into pulp. Pulp can be used to make paper. This paper is used for making flowers and paper plates. Models can be made from cloth pulp. Diversity in clothes. Due to cultural and geographical differences, there is diversity in clothes and clothing styles. Due to climate, people select a particular fabric and a dress. Special clothes are worn during festivals, celebrations, special occasions, etc. In Maharashtra, majority of the people use cotton clothes. There is always change in the clothing and dressing pattern as per the time. Earlier people had different style of clothing. So student, what we have learned today? Cloth is made from yarn. Yarn may be made from cotton, wool, etc. Clothes become dirty on being used. We must always wear clean clothes. Soaps or natural substances like Rita can be used for washing clothes. Old clothes should not be thrown away. They can be reused. We see diversity in clothing because of cultural and geographical differences. There is a difference in the types of clothing worn in earlier times and those worn today. Do understand the concepts and revise at home. Thank you.